Today we are going to analyze what are all the forces which are acting on this mechanism and how we can resolve those forces so that the entire system is in equilibrium. This is the mechanism which is used in IC engine, okay? The slider crank mechanism. The link 1, so the link 1 is fixed 1, okay? And the link 2 is, we call that as crank, okay? So it is a crank as far as IC engine is concerned, okay? And the link 3 is connecting rod, okay? So it is the connecting rod, okay? And here this link 4 is, it is piston, okay? And so the link 1 is fixer and the link 2 is crank and the link 3 is connecting rod and the link 4 is piston, okay? And the external force is acting on the piston, okay? And here it is a translatory motion. That means the piston moves to and fro, okay, this direction. On the other hand, the crank which rotates about this pivoted point O, okay? So the translatory motion in piston is converted into rotary motion at the crank, okay? This is what the slider crank mechanism is, okay? So now we are going to consider the entire slider crank mechanism is in equilibrium condition, okay? So if the entire system is in equilibrium, means each and every link in the mechanism is also in the equilibrium condition. Say for example, this crank, connecting rod, piston. So these three links are in equilibrium. So we are going to find out the forces which are acting on each links, okay? So that is what the thing that we are going to do right now, okay? First, let us take the piston, okay? So we have to think of how many forces are acting on the piston, okay? It is very clear that piston is subjected to an external force called P. So that is the only external force exist here. But the other two forces also acting on the piston. How? The one force which is acting along the connecting rod, okay? A force which is acting on the piston due to the joint of piston with the connecting rod. So the connecting rod offer a reaction on the piston along its length, okay? So it is one force, okay? What about the other force? Because here it is moving on a fixed link piston. So here there will be a reaction force. So how many forces are there? So I'll take it that link outside from this system, that is free body diagram of link 4, okay? So here this is the piston, okay? So it is a piston and it is subjected to an external force P, okay? So it is the link 4, okay? For your understanding, I'm just marking that as 4, okay? So there is an external force P, okay? It is a gas force which moves the piston in the forward direction, okay? And then I'm just removing this fixed support, okay? Or just like simple support here, the piston moves over this surface, that is piston cylinder, okay? So here the cylinder, piston cylinder offers a reaction, okay? So it is acting in the upward direction, okay? Are you clear about that? Okay, so now what is the direction of the another force which is acting on the piston? It is acting along the length of the connecting rod, okay? So here is that force, okay? And this force is we can just name it as F3 4. That means the force of connecting rod 3 on the link piston 4, okay? So F3 4. But actually I don't know the exact direction, but I know the line of action of this force, but I don't know exactly the direction, whether it is moving this direction or in this direction. I don't know about that. Okay, so in order to find out the direction, so we are going to apply the equilibrium condition. Okay, I told you the entire system is in equilibrium condition, so the link 4 is also in equilibrium condition. So if a system is subjected to three force, okay, the piston is subjected to three forces, so it should be in equilibrium. How it is possible? So these three forces must join together and form a triangle. Okay, so that is what the condition of a three force system to be in equilibrium. Okay, so let me draw the force polygon. Okay, so that must be a triangle. At the end you have to get the triangle. If you get the triangle, then the entire forces are resolved. That means the system is in equilibrium condition. So let me try that triangle. Okay, so I'm going to construct the triangle by using polygon law. So what is the polygon law? Which says each and every force has to be considered as the sides of the polygon in magnitude as well as direction. Okay, so what is the polygon law? So we have to take that each and every force as the side of the polygon in terms of magnitude as well as direction, then we have to start drawing the polygon. Okay, the first force I considered is the P because I know the direction, so it is going to be like this. Okay, and then another force is R. It is also going to be like this because it is moving in the upward direction. So obviously this force which connects these two points, okay, which must have a direction like this, that is F3 4, then only the polygon will be a closed one. It is the condition of equilibrium. Okay, do you understand what I am saying? Okay, so if a 3-4 system must be in equilibrium, means if you draw the polygon, then it ends up in a triangle. Okay, then there is no unbalanced force, the system is completely balanced. Okay, so now I know the direction of this force, it is this direction, that is F3 4. So now only I can exactly know what is the direction of the force 3 4. Okay, so it is a 3-4 system. How it is acted upon by three forces? One is external force P, another one is reaction force, because the piston is sliding over the piston cylinder, so it is fixed. Okay, the piston cylinder is, so the piston cylinder import a reaction force on the piston, so that is R. Okay, another force is coming from the connecting rod, because connecting rod and piston are connected together. So while drawing free body diagram, I have to remove this link, okay, this link 3, okay, that is connecting rod. So it offers a reaction on the piston. I know the direction by drawing the polygon law, that is this direction. So now F3 4 is moving in this direction. So now I understood that how many forces are acting on the piston, and also I constructed the force polygon by using that three forces. Okay, so now I just completed the free body diagram of the link 4. Okay, so now let us move on to the connecting rod. Okay, that is free body diagram of link 3. Okay, so it's very clear that this link, that is first, what you have to do is you have to separate the body from its surrounding. Okay, that is the first step. Okay, this is the link 3. I have just separate it from its surrounding, that means it is connected to crank as well as piston. So what I have done is I have just removed it from its surrounding. So I have just removed it. Okay, so now I'm just going to mark the dimensions, its forces. Okay, so what are all the forces? So here it is subjected to two forces, because one force from piston, another force from the crank. So what are those? The first forces, I can easily write those force. Okay, that is F4 3. Okay, this F3 4 and F4 3 are equal in magnitude, only they got opposite direction. Okay, so if the F3-4 is moving this direction, F4-3 is going to be moving in this direction. Okay, so both are equal and opposite. Okay, and if this force is acting this direction, then in order to balance this force, obviously there will be some forces which is acting along this direction with same magnitude. That is F, this one is 2, so F 2, 3. Okay, so the force of crank on the connecting rod, it is the force of piston on the connecting rod, F 4, 3 and F 2, 3. Okay, for a system to be in equilibrium, two force system, what is the condition? F 4, 3. F43 must be equal to F23, and we also know that F34 is also equal to F43, so both are equal and opposite because it is Newton's third law. Okay, so now we have resolved all the forces which are acting on the connecting rod because it is subjected to two forces, one is from the piston, another one is from crank. I can just initially know the direction of this force, that is force from the piston from the free body diagram of the piston. So I just consider the same line of action here, that is F43, because both are equal and opposite, and this force must be along its direction for this connecting rod to be in equilibrium and also equal in magnitude. So F43 is equal to F23. Okay, it's clear. So now moving on to a crank. Okay, so the free body diagram of the crank, okay, that is so link 2. Okay, so first thing what I have to do is I have to draw this link. Okay, fine. Okay, and I know one force. What is this force? So it is acting on that connecting rod F23. So here the same direction this force is acting, that is F32. The force of connecting rod on the crank, this F23 and F32 are equal. Okay, so from this free body diagram I understood that the direction of this force is along the length of the connecting rod, so it is acting this direction, so F32 is supposed to be acting in the opposite direction. Okay, so now just think of this crank. Okay, so one force I understood that it is a reaction from this connecting rod because of this joint. Okay, and what are all the other forces which are acting on the connecting rod? So let us think about that, because it is also supported. So definitely whenever the motion is restricted there will be a reaction, but what should be the direction of that reaction force? That is interesting. Okay, because for piston I have just taken it is exactly at the perpendicular direction. Okay, on the other hand, so here how I can just take this reaction force, that is F12. Okay, F12. So what is the direction? Okay, so interestingly, for this system to be in equilibrium, it is the length of the crank. If this system to be in equilibrium means there must be a force, okay, there must be a force which is parallel to the F32 and parallel to the F32 and equal in magnitude as that of F32. So that is F12 is equal to F32 and it must be parallel to this force. So then what would happen? These two forces will form a couple. Okay, so what would be the direction of this couple? It is obviously a clockwise direction couple. Okay, because it is moving the link in this direction and it is moving the link in this direction, so it will form a clockwise couple. Okay, so it form a couple, so there must be a couple in this link so that this couple is counterbalanced. Okay, it has been nullified so that the system is in equilibrium. So the crank is subjected to two forces and a couple. Okay, so now you can clearly understood that what are all the forces which are acting in a slider crank mechanism. So initially what we have done, we have separated each and every link from the mechanism. First we just started from piston. Piston is subjected to three forces. One is external force, one is force from connecting rod, another one is reaction force from this link one. Okay, so either you can take that as R, or otherwise you can just represent that as F1 4. Okay, so piston is subjected to three forces, and we have resolved those forces and we know what is the direction of this force F43. Then coming to connecting rod, it is subjected to two forces, so we know the direction of F43. So the next force must be equal and opposite to the tough this force and should be in the same line of action. Okay, that is F43 is equal to F23. Fine. Okay, so it is a two force system. We have found out all the forces which are acting on the connecting rod. Only two forces. Just moving on to crank. So here there may be one forces from connecting rod to crank. Okay, forces acting from connecting rod to crank, that is F32. It must be equal and opposite, so it is easily understood. And the next force is the reaction from the this fixed support, so it must be parallel to this known force, because we don't know exactly where it is acting. But how to mark this force? If the system, if it is in equilibrium condition, mean it must be parallel to this force and equal in magnitude. So I've just drawn this force just exactly parallel to this F32 and equal in magnitude. Okay, so that is F32 is equal to F12. Okay, so now as a result of these two forces, it will form a couple. Okay, so when couple is there, the system is not in equilibrium condition. So in order to balance that, okay, we need to add another couple in the counterclockwise direction so that the entire system will be balanced. Okay, so this is all about the static force analysis in a slider crank mechanism. So the result of this analysis, we have come to know that how many forces are acting on individual elements. Okay, that means piston, connecting rod and crank. Okay, so based on that, we can use this idea for dynamic analysis in the same slider crank mechanism. Because before getting into dynamic force analysis, initially we must know what are all the forces acting on individual element. Okay, so then only we can use dynamic analysis to solve the problem in slider crank mechanism. Okay, so thank you.